Hello, everybody. I am Marcus Fartskin, host of Channel 7 News. Today, I will be interviewing Rudy Ethanhouse, the host of The Late Show. Come on, Rudy. Hello, Rudy. Tell us a joke.
Okay, so it's election year, and everyone's like, who to vote for? Well, I have a candidate I'm endorsing that you might not think you would endorse. The candidate I'm endorsing is Georgie the dog, who's 2 years old, and a dog. What makes her great is you can never say she voted yes on the Iraq War in 2003.
That is the worst joke I've ever heard.
Why, you little... Welcome to The Late Show. I'm Rudy Ethanhouse, your host. We cover everything and anything Donald Trump related. So, I was watching YouTube recently. Like, a lot of people watch YouTube and they're bored. It's like, hey, let's watch some music. So, I was watching this old video of Donald Trump being interviewed on The Late Show with David Letterman. And I felt something was off. And I finally realized what it was. He wasn't being racist. Brought to you by Scotch Brite Sponges, the kind you wash your dishes with, and also what Donald Trump puts on his head every day. Thank you, good night.
Ow, thanks for watching our show at Channel 7 News. I'm the host, and I will see you guys next time. Ready!
From historic Pacific Coast TV studios at Pacifica Commerce Center, it's The Daily Report with Rudy Ethanhouse. Tonight. Musical performances by Rudy Ethanhouse. And now, please welcome your host, Rudy Ethanhouse.
Welcome to The Daily Report. I'm your host, Rudy Ethanhouse. All right. So, the 2024 election is coming up. And I have a political candidate to endorse. I know. It's exciting to try and keep it down. It is my chicken, Poppy Seed. Say what you will about Poppy Seed, but she has never voted for the war in Iraq.
The worst joke I've ever heard.
Well, can you do better?
Yeah.
All right, we'll see about that later. So, recently, the Pacifica Planning Commission discussed hauling in a bunch of soil to allow development of the quarry. Wow, I've heard of dirty politics, but this is something else. Has anyone heard about the new Indiana Jones film, The Dial of Destiny? It's bombing at the box office. That's right, you don't have to watch Oppenheimer to see something crash and burn. Do you know what the difference is between Joe Biden and Poppy Seed the Chicken? One is a stupid, mindless creature that is easily swayed by someone handling them, and the other is a chicken. You know, apparently they're making Legos with anxiety issues now. That's great, but it will never equal the anxiety I've felt after I've stepped on a Lego in my bare feet once. I live in constant fear. All right, that is it for the monologue. Coming up next, we've got a special visit from King Charles III, who is going to give us his top 10 decrees. We'll be right back. The Lego.
Tonight I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the wall, it's turning inside out. Yeah, I'm floating. Tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by a clinging diver. I'm gonna go, go, go. There's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky. 200 degrees is why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm driving at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic. Such a good time, I'm having a ball. Don't stop me now. If you wanna have a good time, just give me a call. Don't stop me, cause I'm having a good time. Don't stop, cause I'm having a good time. I don't wanna stop at all. I'm a rocket ship on my way to Mars. On the collision course, I am a satellite. I'm out of control, I'm a sex machine ready to reload, like an atom bomb about to explode. I'm burning through the sky. 200 degrees is why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm driving at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic man of the year. Don't stop me, don't stop me, don't stop me. Don't stop me, don't stop me, ooh. Don't stop me, don't stop me, have a good time, don't stop me, don't stop me. That's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm driving at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic moment in you.
Hello, my loyal subjects. Now here are my top 10 decrees. Number 10, rent out Buckingham Palace as an Airbnb. Number 9, make everyone drive a horse and carriage to combat climate change. Number 8, appoint the Queen's corgis as the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. Number 7, sell my crown to cash for gold. Number 6, remove the Burger King from the line of succession because he is a Protestant. Number 5, reduce the expenses of the royal family by getting rid of their 10% discount at Jack in the Box. Number four, return Prince Harry for store credit. Number three, deep fry all the swans. Number two, use my crown as a bowl for guacamole. And the number one, divorce Camilla, marry the Dairy Queen. We'll be right back, everyone. Welcome back to the Daily Report. Election season is right around the corner, and our next guest has just announced his candidacy for President of the United States. Please welcome Vato Blanco III. Hey, wake up, man. Wake up.
What?
Well, it looks like your campaign has got off to a rocky start.
Who are you again? And where am I?
You're on the Daily Report being interviewed for your presidential candidacy.
I am? You got coffee?
Sure, man. Hey, you good, man?
Yeah, I'm good. Just, you know, rough morning.
Oh, all right then. So, I see you are wearing a 1700s style wig. Don't you think that makes you seem out of touch and stuck in the past? What's with those sunglasses?
That's my hair, bro. It's real, see? You wanna give it a tug?
All right, let's see. Yeah, it definitely
see?
Is real.
See, it's real. All right, these sunglasses are for the hangover I have. Like I said, well, maybe I haven't said this to you yet, but I've been hitting the sauce a little too much last night, hence the coffee.
I can see that, jeez. Well, which political party are you running for?
I am proud to be representing the Federalist Party. And that is because, you know, the feds, they've been giving me so many problems. I thought, you know, if you can't beat them, you got to join them.
Okay. A lot of candidates are making campaign promises. What will you do once in office?
So, let me think. What should I do? I think I have this written down because I'm pretty sure I planned this before I had my partying last night. Yes, I do. So here it says that I will $20 on January the 1st for blocking driveway accident. Parked in a fire lane, $50. Vehicle no valid parking for $200 on the 1st. What is this? Maybe I think this is it. Give me 1 second. Sorry
okay.
about that. To the defendant, Vato Blanco III, this letter is to notify you that you are required to appear for a court-ordered hearing before the judge, Radfink Edding Schetz, at the Pacifica Courthouse in room number 0 at the following address, 1234 Pacific Road. This hearing will address the following issues and concerns: parking violation on 1380 Linda Marr Shopping Center, racketeering, treason. Okay. This hearing will take place on July 13th at 4:20 a.m. / p.m. Well, which one is it?
I don't know. Maybe it's both.
Maybe it's both. Okay.
Now, wait a minute. Is that a notice to appear in court?
Oh, yeah. Look at that. City of Pacifica versus me. Can you believe that? Run this through the shredder. You got one? I'm not going to it. I'm not paying those tickets either. You can run those as well.
Oh my God. Now hold on a second. My floor manager has just informed me that your car has been towed, and apparently you parked on the roof of the studio.
Ain't my car. I got rid of it so I wouldn't have to pay those parking tickets. Ain't that smart, huh?
I guess so. Jeez. So, what kinds of campaign promises do you have?
So, when you go to like the shopping mall, they got that red sidewalk with a fire lane, they call it. Those are now, we're going to make it so, you know, red is good. So anyone can park in the red fire lanes because, you know, ask yourself this, how many times have you seen a fire truck actually there?
Well, I mean, they need that because, you know, in an emergency.
I've only seen it once, okay, in my whole life. Or I've seen a lot of stuff, but only one fire truck in that red space once in my whole life. That's why they should be legal for anyone to park there. All right. So another thing that, another thing that I want to do is I want to legalize parking almost anywhere. For example, mall fountains. I once accidentally parked into a mall fountain going very high speeds. And according to the police, that was, property destruction and reckless driving. And that wasn't very cool. But, you know, before they rolled me out of there, I took some pennies in the fountain and kind of broke even. So, you know, joke's on them.
Okay, moving on. Is it true that you used to own an ice cream shop?
Yeah, I actually did.
So what happened to that?
So I introduced a Rocky Road flavor using actual rocks from Lake Tahoe. Can you believe that? And, that didn't last long because apparently, according to the FDA, that's a health and safety violation. And those shit-eating rats, they shut me down. So no more ice cream shop for me. Makes no sense to me because those are the cleanest rocks in the state. Can you, like, the cleanest?
I guess so. Well, you know.
You ever seen Tahoe rocks?
I have seen them, yes.
Aren't they clean?
They are very clean.
So what do you think their problem is?
I don't know. I mean, but, you know, who needs them anyway? I mean, you could just abolish the FDA once you get into office, right?
I like the way you think. That's exactly what I'm going to do.
Anyway, so let's get back to the subject at hand. Why should people vote for you?
Well, I've made a bunch of videos to show why I am best fit for the presidency. And I believe it has really resonated with some people, some voters.
How many people watched it?
About 20. You know, 18 of them were my homies.
That's a pretty low number.
I mean, it might be, but last time I checked, I'm getting more views than you are on your channel, so your YouTube channel.
All right. How do you plan to help the economy?
I will raise the presidential minimum wage, which will, you know, only benefit me, of course. You'll let me live my life in my mansion in Beverly Hills. And I'll make sure that all of your tax money comes to...
Oh, it looks like you're getting a call on your phone.
Oh, crap. Hello? Yeah? They're raiding the ice cream shop? Yeah? Okay, yeah. Hey, man, it was nice talking to you, but I gotta get out of here. All right, personal business, bye.
Jesus Christ. You know, who let this guy into the studio? Well, we've got to take a break. We will be right back.
Can lead to diabetes and risk of heart attack? Now that's a lot of damage! But with onions, you can cheat that. And it'll even give you eye lasers. And they even work underwater. Buy onion now for 20 easy payments of $49.99. Totally not worm infested. Thank you for watching The Daily Report. That's the show. Good night.